Hi, welcome to the Gate Academy. I am Deepanshu Bansal, Vice President, Academic Relations. Today we have Mr. Ravi Mishra with us. Mr. Ravi Mishra is the serial Gate topper. He has got AIR 1 in Gate 2015 and has again scored AIR 3 in Gate 2017. Congratulations, Ravi.
Thanks a lot.
So, Ravi, people find it difficult to get rank once. You have done it twice. So, how are you feeling?
Oh, it's a great feeling to achieve what you dream of. I prepared really hard in last year's attempt also in 2015. And this year also, I prepared with a lot of dedication. So, it's like a dream come true to achieve what you have thought or what you are working for a long time.
Okay. So, Ravi, can you please tell us about your academic background, as in what you have done till now?
Okay, so I did my BTech from IIT Kanpur in mechanical stream. After BTech, I got placed in Bosch. It's a Bangalore-based company. And but I decided to take a drop and prepare for GATE in computer science. And in 2015, I wrote the GATE examination and got All India Rank 1. And this year also, at the end of my M.Tech, I wrote the examination and got Rank 3 in CS stream. So this was my journey till late.
Okay, so you switched branches. You give first you were a mechanical student. You give GATE in CS stream. You topped the GATE examination, you took admission, and then you again get the GATE examination, and then you again topped it. That's very interesting to know. So Ravi, you got a job, right? You got placed in Bosch, as you said, and after that, you decided to forego that job to pursue your higher studies, and that too in a different stream. So you switched from mechanical to CS. Why you did that?
Okay, so I have a couple of options after graduating, after completing my BTech from IIT Kanpur.
Yeah.
One was the job. Mm-hmm. In Bosch, but actually I researched the job profile a bit with my seniors. I have a chat with them. So most of them said that it was a management related job, but I wanted to pursue the technical field. So I thought that it's better that I should like switch or rather than going to that job and ultimately ending in some management type of work or something like that. So apart from job, there were three other options that I explored. One was the doing masters at US. Okay. So I got admitted at University of Urbana-Champaign.
Okay.
So I talked with a senior there. Mm. So he said that actually it's pretty getting really difficult for outsiders of US, means people who are not from US, okay, to get a job in core field there. Means basically there are jobs in railways, but now they are restricted only to the US citizen only.
Okay.
So railways was the most major people who hires the mechanical
engineers. Okay.
So that's why that option was not very promising.
Okay.
The other option was MS in Germany, but there also I talked to the senior who got who was exactly studying in that university in which I got the admission.
Okay.
So the major issue in Germany is that after completing your M.Tech there, the major deciding factor of what quality of job you get is the language, whether you know the German language well or not.
Okay.
So even if your technical skills are very good, then if you cannot communicate well with the clients, okay, then you will end up with like not so good job there.
Okay.
And the third option was doing PhD from Australia.
Okay.
So it was a 3-year program.
Okay.
And means the major thing was that I researched, I also talked few seniors there and people who are doing like masters or postdoc there in University of Melbourne, where I got the PhD. So PhD offer. So they were saying that it's better to go to US because the 3-year PhD is not that much effective. Like it don't add too much value to your profile.
Okay.
So all of them were suggesting that better you do PhD from US.
Okay.
And so I thought that rather than like investing 3 years in PhD in Melbourne, it's better that I try to switch my branch and move to some field
okay,
which have like high demand in terms of job perspective or learning perspective.
Okay.
So that's why I switched to computer science.
Okay. So you researched all the options that were present to you, and,
yes,
and then you come to the conclusion that it's much better to switch your branch because the kind of jobs you wanted were not there in mechanical.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
So Ravi, you decided to switch your branch to CS. Then after you decided this, why did you decide to take GATE examination rather than directly applying to foreign universities for CS courses?
Okay, I thought about this option also.
Mm-hmm.
But most of the US universities take a holistic view of taking the admission of the students.
Right.
Means it's they look at your CGPA, your GRE score, your TOEFL score, and your statement of purpose, your letter of recommendation, a lot of things.
Right.
So actually, my profile was not that strong in computer science. I have just done a few, one or two projects because some of my courses were related to coding.
Okay.
So I just have those things to showcase in my profile.
Okay.
So even if I have applied for some US university, most probably I would have landed in some tier 3 university.
Hmm.
So it was much better that I go to IIT Bombay rather than them, because anyway IIT Bombay is ranked above all that tier 3 universities. So I thought that it's better to write gate exam and choose for like IIT Bombay or ISC. Okay.
So instead of going for tier 3 universities, it is much better that you studies in IITs in India.
Yeah.
Ravi, so you topped gate examination one in 2015.
Yes.
Then why did you choose to give gate examination again in 2017?
Actually, I wanted to have a backup plan for my placement things.
Okay.
This year I was sitting for my placement in December.
Mm-hmm.
But placement is something that is not very sure. Like if you target for some company, a few things goes wrong, you mm-hmm. could not answer one question well, or some interview goes bad,
right.
and you ended up in some other company.
Right.
So basically I wanted to have a backup in I kind of have a backup for my job. Basically the PSUs that we have through the gate examination.
Okay.
So in the September the gate examination forms were out.
Mm-hmm.
So I just filled them.
Okay.
So that in case my placement doesn't go according to my plan,
hmm.
then I could go for like PSUs.
Okay.
And since the result of PSU, for PSU you need the result of that year of gate exam only.
Right.
So my 2015 result were not valid.
Okay.
I need to give the exam again.
Okay.
So that I can like appear for the interviews of the PSU.
Okay.
Based on this year rank.
Okay. So you basically give gate exam again for the PSUs.
Yeah, right.
So Ravi, you have mastered the art of taking gate examination. So students would like to know that how did you prepare? What should be the preparation strategy for the gate examination?
Okay. So the major steps in the preparation for the gate examination were, first of all, you have to gain the knowledge about all the topics that we have in the gate examination. There are a couple of ways by which you can do that. Means either you can follow some standard book, or you can see some video lectures, or you can go for some study material, or maybe some renowned coaching. So whatever suits you. Means basically you need to get a overall picture that what all topics are in the gate examination, and you have to be having thorough understanding about them. So this is the first thing. And the second thing is that then you can go for like previous year questions of the gate exam. So what I did is that I used to complete one topic and I used to solve the previous year gate questions. So you can kind of follow the same thing, because then your memory will be very refreshed when you study something and you solve the question. So there are high chances that you might be able to solve a lot of questions in the same topic.
Okay.
So after doing previous year question, I used to revise the things again and again, because many times it happened that there are like 10-12 subjects. So you need to keep revising after like 15 days. So if you have studied something like 1 month ago, 2 months ago, so keep revising that and like give 1-2 days and revise that thing so that it don't get completely erased from your mind.
Okay.
And apart from that, I give test series so that I can like get used to that pressure thing, because in generally you have to in the exam you have to solve like 65 questions in 3 hours, so you need to manage your time well and be cool in that situation. So a test series helped to like get a scenario in which is very similar to actual exam, and you want to give your best in that period. So this was my basic strategy for gate preparation.
Okay, so basically gain the concepts,
yeah,
and then practice on this and then revise the concepts.
Yeah.
So Ravi, you were talking about the importance of the test series and practicing tests. So how did the Gate Academy help you?
Okay, so I appeared for the online test series of Gate Academy. So it basically helped me to find out the areas where I was making recurring mistakes.
Okay.
So I appeared for the full length test series, and when I used to analyze my paper and find out where all I am making mistake in which topics. And then I go back and I study that topic again so that I do not make again
the same mistake
again in like the next paper.
Okay.
So this was one thing. The other thing was time management. It's very important that
You plan your time very well in the examination. You have 3 hours to solve 65 questions. So you need to learn that when you have to move on and how much time you need to devote in what type of question. Because if you waste too much time in one question, it will lead to the mental tension that you are lagging behind and all.
So it
helped me in time management. You again give a full length test. You know where to save time and where to devote your time. And the third thing was the interface. By giving the mock test, you understand the interface of the actual gate exam. How to navigate to the next question, how to save your question, and how to use calculator. Because nowadays only virtual calculator is allowed, so you must be knowing how to use it. So you after practicing with the mock test, you feel at ease when you appear for the actual examination. So this is how the GATE Academy helped me for my GATE preparation.
So Ravi, any advice for your juniors?
Okay, there are a few advices for you. First of all, a lot of people think that it's a very difficult exam. GATE is very difficult to crack. But it's not. Basically, you just need to know the GATE syllabus very well, the topics that are present there. And you have to be thorough with each and every topic. Most of the questions are like pretty straightforward. They don't twist the question too much. They directly try to understand how broad your knowledge is. There are a lot of topics, but you can go one topic at a time and can gain a thorough knowledge about each and every one of them, because all are asked in the exam.
Okay.
So there's nothing to panic. Make a plan that how you are going to go about it. Choose what method, like standard books or coaching or whichever that suits you, and stick with that plan and work hard for your goal. And you will, like, it's not pretty easy, but it's not very tough also. It's not something that only like very intelligent or very genius people can crack. Anyone can do the GATE exam. Anyone can get crack the GATE examination. And after cracking the GATE examination, it opens a lot of options for like research work or job. For job, you can, if you directly want to get into a job, you can go for PSU. Or if you want to study a bit more and then go for a job, then you can go for M.Tech, complete M.Tech in 2 years, and after that you can take job in some company, whichever interests you. And for research, the option is like you can either directly pursue PhD, after B.Tech you can directly go for PhD with GATE, or you can do M.Tech from some good IITs or IIC, and then if you choose, you can also go to a PhD abroad after your M.Tech. So yes, there are a lot of options, and I'll say them to be just confident about their skills and work hard for the GATE examination.
So Ravi, whom you would like to dedicate your success to?
Okay, I dedicate my success first of all to my parents, because I have made some tough calls in my life, and they were in full support. I left my job, I thought of switching my streams. So in every phase of my life, they were in my support. They never discouraged me, or they never demotivated me that you won't be able to do it. They were always very encouraging and motivating. And of course, to my seniors, a lot of time in my life, I have to ask them about advice about my career. So they helped me to guide well that what will be my exact plot of life if I choose some option. And of course, to the GATE Academy test series, it helped me to like feel at ease in the actual GATE examination, because the practice that I gained here helped me a lot, like to save my marks in say negative marking and all, because I could identify the mistakes that I was making again and again, and of course in time management and all. So these are the people that I would like to dedicate my success.
Thank you, Ravi. Thank you for talking to us.
Thanks
a lot.
It
was very good to talk to you, and your inputs would definitely help a lot of students. So this video is going to be part of our Topper's Talk initiative, where we call TGA toppers and discuss them how they prepared and what they can do. Okay. So thank you once again. Thanks for the time.
Thanks a lot for having me here.
So here was Mr. Ravi. We were interacting with him. He is one of the GATE Academy toppers, has secured AIR 1 in 2015 and AIR 3 in 2017. So, Mr. Ravi has switched his branch from mechanical to computer science, and in spite of that, he was able to secure such good ranks. So, GATE exam actually helped him to broaden his horizons. It opened a lot of opportunities for him. So, I hope that this video helps you. in deciding your career paths. And if you really like the video, please click the subscribe button to get the regular updates. Thank you. Thanks a lot.